Well, it'll be the first time we've heard from him since Bad Blood, and I can't wait.
And
we have company.
Yes, we do. We have a visitor. And he was not expected to join us.
Sorry, Vince, I know you wanted the big introduction. You want to be standing up here beside me, but I've got something to say, and I'm going to say it right now. Last week, on Monday Nitro, Jeff Jarrett was declared everything but dead. Since I refuse to accept Eric Bischoff's offer and re-sign with WCW, he did everything within his power to bury me. Being the coward that he is, he even hid behind his computer and announced to the whole world that he had pulled the offer off the table. Well, Eric, the only thing that you ever pulled from Jeff Jarrett was opportunity. Since I wasn't one of your boys, you put a lid on my potential. I was only going to go as far as you wanted me to. There was never, ever any ladder of success for me to climb.
Very candid comments from Jeff Jarrett.
I was one of the youngest, most talented wrestlers that you had, Eric. But you let me drown in mediocrity just because my stroke wasn't strong enough. Look who you booked me with, an ex-football player who can't even lock up. And his wife, she gives new meaning to the phrase dumb blonde. Vince, don't sit over there and snicker and smile and cherish this moment, because I left the WWF 2 years ago for the same reason. Eric Bischoff did it out of either ignorance or inexperience of the wrestling business. What were your excuses? Remember the gold tooth?
The gold tooth.
Yeah, you think it's real cute and funny. Remember the gold tooth, the country music star? Vince, you had a vision of what you wanted Double J, Jeff Jarrett, to be. And quite honestly, in all due respect, your vision sucked.
Yeah, it may have.
You booked me with a clown, a drug addict,
good Lord,
a black man who can't even speak the English language. Vince, you tried to bury me and you tried to kill me off, but you didn't get the job done. I guess you figured, since you didn't put my dad out of business, just like you put every other wrestling promoter out in the 80s, since you couldn't do that, you figured the next best thing would be to kill his son off. Well, Vince, not only did I survive, but I walked out on you. And how ironic that is, that we make a deal and get back together, and you pay me, that's right, you pay me a whole lot more money the second go around. And you know why, Vince? You know why? Because you need Jeff Jarrett. You need me to put people in seats and ratings on the board.
Oh, we're doing pretty
good. Vince, you told me to come out here tonight and shoot, and that's exactly what I'm doing. Right between your eyes. You can take with my baby tonight and stick it up your butt. Because from here on out, it's going to be Jeff Jarrett's way. And if you try, that's exactly right, if you try to stop me, fine. I'll gladly pack my bag and walk right out the door again. But Vince, I've got a question to ask you. Can you afford it? I don't think so, or you wouldn't have paid me all that money just 5 days ago. Now,
very
on with
comment.
The state of affairs,
I guess.
in the World Wrestling Federation. Bret Hart, the best there was. Bret, you are so right. With was being the key word. All your past accomplishments, you've been living on name recognition. All the respect you've gained over the last 15 years, well, that runs out tonight. And Shawn Michaels, physically, this guy can only wrestle once a week. And he's proud of that. He's proud of that. Shawn, you call yourself the showstopper, the main eventer, the icon that can still go. Well, I got a question. How often can you go? It seems lately all you do is run around here, put silly little signs, point at your crotch, and give your little hand signals to your boys in Atlanta. Shawn, one day you were the main event. You were WWF champion. You were the attraction. But now all you are is reduced, because you're so broken down, to hiding behind your infantile attitude.
And right,
speaking
right.
of attitude, what about Steve Austin? Now here's a guy who has lowered himself to shaving his head and coming out here every week, not once or twice, but 10 or 15 times, and saying the word ass. That's right. Saying the word ass just to get a reaction, just to get noticed. Stone Cold, no. Stone Cold, you will always be the ringmaster. And as far as your...
Ladies and gentlemen,
Stone Cold, as far as your blasphemous merchandise, that offends me. Austin 316 offends me, because what you're doing is ripping off the Bible to put
please.
Money
Good
in your grief. Pocket.
Hey, you get what you
when
pay for, McMahon. Don't try to stop him now.
Oh,
shut the
it's
mic
gonna
off.
Be your judgment day.
Yeah.
Vince, you wanted the real Jeff Jarrett tonight? Well, you got him. I just hope your investment's gonna be worth all your headaches.
And certainly so do we.